Understanding the Logos, Episode 6, Message Title, Hebrews Chapter 1, The New World Bible Translation, Review. The New World Translation of the Bible is the work of the Watchtower Bible Society, popularly known as Jehovah Witness. It is a translation crafted purposely to support its doctrines. While I cannot treat all their doctrines in just one episode, I only would be able to address those relating to the translation of Hebrews chapter 1, that concerns the deity of Christ. The book of Hebrews, especially chapter 1, was written to prove five major points about Christ, as I noted in the last episode. These points I stated poses a major problem to the doctrine of the Jehovah Witness, about the deity of the Son of God. What is of particular interest to me today is their workaround for the challenges Hebrews chapter 1 poses to Jehovah Witness doctrine of Christ. Their first improvisation to this holy text is in verse 6. This verse asserts that before Christ descent into the womb of Mary, God commanded all the heavenly hosts to worship Him. Since Christ is not God or divine in their belief, they used the English word obeisance instead of the word worship for this verse. Hebrews chapter 1 verse 6 New World Translation reads, "But when He again brings His firstborn into the inhabited earth, He says, 'And let all of God's angels do obeisance to Him.'" The Greek word here translated obeisance, the New World Translation of the Watchtower Tract and Bible Society, the Jehovah Witness, but as worship in other Bible translations, is the Greek word proskuneo, meaning to kiss like a dog licking his master's hand, to fawn or crouch to, that is, literally or figuratively, prostrate oneself in homage, do reverence, to adore, worship. Of its 55 occurrences in the New Testament, 15 references to Jesus, that is 27%. But not in a singular time was it translated worship, relative to Christ, in the New World Translation of the Witness, but in every other of its occurrence regarding Satan, devil or demons, idols or God, they, in bias, duly translated it, worship. It is a scriptural fact that when men are struck by the awe of the supernatural, they tend to proskuneo or worship the miracle worker. 1 Corinthians 14:24 and 25, Cornelius tried doing that to Peter, Acts 10:25. Even John the Beloved tried to worship the angel sent to give him his revelations, but God's angels always refuse the worship proskuneo of men, Revelations 19:10 and 22-9. Prophets and angels of God refuse proskuneo, but Jesus as God, on the other hand, receives them. John 9:38 and He said, "Lord, I believe," and he worshipped, proskuneo Him, Matthew 28:9. And when they saw Him, they worshipped Him, but some doubted, also in Matthew 2:2 and many other scriptures. Jesus always receives the worship of men, God's angels, and demons, unlike men of God and God's angels, that refuses it, because He is due to do so, as God, Revelation 5:13-14. In Daniel chapter 7 verses 13-14, God commanded the whole of humanity to serve the Son of Man, Christ the Messiah. The particular Bible word translated here serve, only appear in the book of Daniel, and only for 10 times in the entire Bible. It also means to worship or minister. 9 times it was translated as serve, and 1 time as minister. In its every occurrence as serve, it can be substituted with worship. For example, Nebuchadnezzar demanded that people bow down to serve or worship his idol of gold, but Daniel's and his friends refused. Therefore, in contrast to the Nebuchadnezzar's demand that the world served or worshipped his idols of gold, the Ancient of Days bin Daniel 7, 14 and 17 commands humanity to worship or serve the Son of Man. This is the point the Hebrews author was making. Jesus is greater than prophets and angels that not only refused worship but were also bowed down in worship to Christ, Hebrews 1:6. And again, when He bringeth in the first begotten into the world, He saith, "And let all the angels of God worshipped, proskuneo Him." Christ receives worship. God even commanded His angels in heaven to worship Him, not merely make obeisance, show courtesy or respect Him, as Watchtower make its followers wrongly believe. The second error in New World's translation of Hebrews chapter 1 is their ploy to shroud the deity of Christ in the Bible, hiding the fact that the Father addressed the Son as God in verses 8-9, verse 8. "But about the Son, He says, 'God is your throne forever and ever, and the scepter of your kingdom is the scepter of uprightness.'" In their ploy in denying the deity of Christ, they make a major blunder, by saying Christ is a greater than the Father, in distorting the translation of the text. Or else what could this mean? God is the throne, the seat that the sun sits on. Listen to their translation again. But about the sun, he says, God is your throne forever and ever. This major blunder would be avoided if they have left this scripture as it is rendered in original Greek, as other translations did. But unto the sun he saith, Thy throne, O God, is forever and ever. A scepter of righteousness is the scepter of thy kingdom. The next blunder committed propping their anti-Trinitarian doctrine is found in verses 10-12. Here they have to break their most important rule of translating. Translate every occurrence of Greek word for Lord, Kurios, in the New Testament to the Old Testament Jehovah, whenever it relates to the divinity of Christ, so as to divert attention away from Christ, making it look as if Jehovah is the exclusive name of the Father. This is unavoidable because, this text cited, Psalms 102, by the New Testament book of Hebrews author in which Jehovah appears 8 times, it's a special prayer to Jehovah, by its Old Testament Hebrew language title. The writer of the Hebrews using this Psalms for Christ, explicitly assert, that Christ Jesus shares the name of Jehovah with his Father. The Old Testament text cited, Psalm 102 from verse 19-25 stated, 25. Of old hast thou laid the foundation of the earth, and the heavens are the work of thy hands. The writer of the book of Hebrews writes, And, thou, Lord, in the beginning hast laid the foundation of the earth, and the heavens are the works of thine hands. The Greek word for Lord in the New Testament Kurios, which under normal circumstances they would have zealously translated to Jehovah, but because here, the book of the Hebrews explicitly linked to Psalm for Jehovah for Christ Jesus the Logos, showing him also as Jehovah the Creator, it was uncharacteristically of them left as Lord, in small caps. Even their translation of the cited Psalm in Hebrews chapter 1, attest to it that the Lord referenced here in Hebrews 1:10 is the Jehovah, God's name, always translated capital Lord in KJV, and not the general word for Lord, Adonai, a title. Psalms 102 verse 19 New World Translation, For he looks down from his holy height, from the heavens Jehovah views the earth. 25, Long ago you laid the foundations of the earth, and the heavens are the work of your hands, message by Reverend Silas, Olufemi, or, if you are blessed by this message please click on the subscribe button, and like my Facebook page, Time of Relief, telephone and WhatsApp number, 23480998638 72, Lagos, Nigeria, Voice TTS.